Hope you guys enjoyed that little bit of an intro clip. That was to retire my old tripod, which is this wonderfully, right now brandless because I ripped off the sticker, I'll leave a link down below, not an affiliate, starter plastic tripod, which worked great for the first 4 months that I had it, even though it actually kind of, I think, came shipped with one less part. It was supposed to have like an extra bolt right here, and you know what, that's not even the point of this video. So yeah, we retired this bad boy, and now we're starting with this new tripod. I would love to show you guys the tripod not in a B-roll shot, but I have to do it in a B-roll shot because I'm using it to film. So I have the Dolica 62-inch tripod. I don't know the model number off the top of my head. I wish I remembered to put a piece of paper in front of me with it, but I didn't. But anyway, ladies and gentlemen, the Dolica 62-inch tripod is an amazing tripod. Right now, it's not at its full 62 inches. It's actually at all three legs, spread out as far as they can go on the normal setting, and by the way, this does have technically four settings, spread out as far as they can, and open to their max length without actually adjusting the middle column. So yeah, you can actually adjust all three of the legs to be as big as they can go, and they are not a twist lock mechanism, they are actually a, what I'm gonna call a clamp lock mechanism, but that's just what they are. So you can actually twist the feet, and the feet actually have like what I'm gonna say a little bit of like a nail in it. It has like a sharp pointy end to it. When you twist the leg or you twist the foot of the last leg, it will actually expose it so you can, if you're shooting on the grass or in a grassy area outside or any terrain that you feel the tripod isn't so sturdy on, you could use that to dig it in a little bit and get it a little bit more sturdy. So now moving up on the tripod, like I said, we have the clamp locks to open them and close them. Very simple. Most tripods have that, or they have a twist, or I don't know, any other mechanism that they would have. But then on top of that, this one has three handle grips, or what, they're really just called grips. I don't know why I'm calling them handle grips. This is great for when you're actually trying to travel with this tripod in a sense. If you're moving from, let's just say, right here to the other side of the room, and you don't want to actually move the camera, you just want to move the tripod, you just pick it up, and you don't have to worry about it ever slipping out of your hand if your hand is a little bit sweaty, which when you're outside it probably would be a little sweaty. Then now for the middle column, before we get into the three features that it has, the middle column actually can be twisted, and this one is one of those twist lock mechanisms. It can be twisted, raised to the full 62 inches, and then locked again, as well as bringing us into our next segment, which is actually talking about how this tripod has four different modes. Right now I'm in the standard mode, which is all three legs out in the standard position, as well as the middle column facing upward. The next thing we have is actually unlocking it a little bit and moving it to the next mode, which is a little bit lower to the ground if you want to try to get like a lower shot. And then we have the third mode, which is actually the lowest you can get with it. Now the fourth mode, which by the way, is a really nice feature for this tripod compared to that old plastic one I had, is if I really wanted to, I can undo the middle column by a very simple thing, and I can actually flip it over so that it's reversed in case I want to get like a downward shot looking straight down at the bottom. Maybe I'm doing an unboxing and I just want it to be right there so that you guys can get like an overhead view. A cool feature about this tripod is that it has a hook in the middle column, and that allows you to put like a sandbag or a book bag, something or other, there so that basically if you're in like a windy condition or you feel like you're in somewhat of an unstable condition, you can use that sandbag, heavy book bag to weigh it down, and basically it pulls it down, weighs it down, so that you have a little bit more stability. This tripod does come with its own ball head, however, I do not recommend ball heads unless you're like doing these crazy shots. So with that, I leave you guys with a card up there, which basically will take you to a video talking about a slider and a fluid head that I do recommend using in a combo. Now, I do recommend using that slider, that fluid head, this tripod, and that ball head all together, and I will show you guys and break that down in a different video on how that all works, and that would probably be sort of my filming setup video. So, one of the key features that I love about every tripod, besides the fact that this one is made of aluminum and that it can hold the amount of weight that I'm putting on it without any resistance at all, without any bending in any of the legs, which that tripod did multiple times. It has a compass, so you know which way is north in case you know you want to get that perfect north shot. But it also actually has a bubble level on it, and bubble levels really help because if you are in some sort of unflat terrain, so basically a rough terrain, you can use that to, you know, adjust the legs where need be, move the ball head maybe so that you get the perfect straight angle shot. And it's just, there's no way to describe it. That's how it is. And another great feature that this tripod does have is, well, on the ball head, it has a quick release plate. So if you guys get multiple of these tripods, or at least multiple of the ball heads, and you want to switch from the standard tripod to maybe a handheld tripod, that quick release plate is there. It's also fairly square. It's still a rectangle, but it is fairly square. So if it, you know, happens to be compatible with any other ball head, let me know if you guys have used this at least with any other ball head or any other mounting mechanism at least, because I know that these quick release plates can be sold separately in case you know you have multiple cameras going to multiple things. You can also buy the ball head separately, so if you're going for multiple things, you can go one after another without having to worry about taking the camera off and then putting it back on, screwing it, putting it in to a different plate. So like I said, I recommend using everything together, but this video is mainly focusing on the Dolica tripod. All information is down below. If you guys are looking to use this tripod for B-roll or time lapses, I really recommend getting a fluid head with it. I know it comes with a ball head, but I recommend getting a fluid head because a fluid head gives you much smoother motions, and the slider will also help with that, but that is not the main key part. If you're doing B-roll, you at least need this awesome fluid. But like I said, that's not the video, so I hope you all did enjoy today's video. Do not forget to rate, comment, and subscribe for more. And as always, have a nice day and stay unique. Links are also in the description. Non-Amazon affiliates.